Hello, everyone, and welcome to part 14 of Space Engines. So, let's keep exploring the universe, shall we? Let's see, what's over here? Have we been to this planet? Have we seen this planet before? Let's head over here, shall we? Oh, also, you may be wondering, why haven't I been posting a lot? Well, it's for, a lot of reasons, but, yeah, it's for a lot of reasons, mostly school and not having the motivation. But don't worry, I have the motivation to do it now, so, yeah. Well, maybe. There's probably going to be lots of videos in the future. Or maybe not. I'm not sure. So, yeah, this planet, a hot, arid, subterranean. Whoa. And, yeah. Look, it's Andromeda again. That was a pretty cool galaxy. There was a lot of cool planets in that galaxy. Tons. Anyways, yeah. Okay, let's check out the next planet. A hot air carbonana. So it has just three asteroids as moons. Okay, then, let me, there we go. I think this is pretty cool. Yeah, this is pretty cool. This planet is pretty cool. There's a massive crater. And yeah. There, I think that's, that's a galaxy, magnetic cloud. And here's, another one. These are also galaxies. These things over there. It feels stranger seeing everything, like looking at stuff in the sky on a planet rather than in, space. Also, here's a volcano. Yeah, anyways, let's keep going. This planet is pretty cool. Next one, all the way over here, is this planet. It seems to have a... Is this a dwarf moon? Thank you. So, yeah. Okay. Interesting looking planet. The moons. Dwarf moon. 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 Dwarf. 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 This one is probably the closest thing to a dwarf moon. Everything else is an asteroid, but this is closest to being a moon. Over here is this planet. Moon. And we have this one. This one looks more closely like the main planet, I feel like. Anyways, let's go to the next one, a cool arid aquaria. That is completely and completely entirely with ice, I think. Okay then. And the moon, which is far more interesting than the planet. Yeah. Okay then, next up, which is probably one of the cooler ones in the solar system, and probably the reason why I chose this one, is this. Look at this planet. Just look at it. It's super cool. Let me try to get a good screenshot. A good thumbnail. Okay, let me, I guess this. Like this. Okay, I need to choose one or the other. Anyways, this planet looks really cool. The rings make it really cool. It's a cool arid carbon nana. And, like, the rings make it look super cool. Whoa. Yeah, it looks pretty cool. Let me just take another photo. So, no, I think the one I got was pretty good. Actually, over here looks pretty fine. Just here and... There we go. I think that looks good. Actually, I think the one let me just take one of the planets itself. Having different screenshots in order to see which is the best one. Anyways, the asteroid. This one kind of looks like a moon. These others look like asteroids, and these two are the closest. These two are the closest to look like moons. Anyways, okay. Let's leave that planet. We spent a lot of time there. Next up is this one. Pretty cool rings. Pretty cool rings. Okay, let's check out the moons. We have this one, which is this one. We have this one. We have this one. This one. This one. This one, and this one, and that one. So that's all the moons here. Okay, so let's head over here. So yeah, the moon, the planet, this one looks closest to being like an astronaut. Like, this is the closest dwarf moon to actually look like a moon. Anyways. Over here is that moon, and over here is another moon. Anyways, the last planet in the solar system is just a frigid Neptune and one moon, which is actually kind of looks cool. Not gonna lie, it looks cool with that blue. Yeah, that's cool. Anyways, that is everything in the solar system. Okay. Robin Star. Let's head over here. That's really far away, actually. Alrighty. Whoa. Let's choose the planet. Let's see the planets. So we have this one, a hot air terraria. This one is a hot air terraria, a warm air terraria. Alright, this one is a temperate sub-oceanic aquaria, though the water is green for some reason. Moons, there's only one actual moon. And, yeah. Next up is a temperate super-oceanic aquaria, which it's pretty cool, especially with those rings. Yeah, this planet has blue water and isn't entirely covered by a layer of cloud, which is a nice change. Anyways, let's check out the, here's the moon, here's one of the moons, and here's another one of the moons. Alrighty. Next up, we have this planet. And, a couple moons. This one. This one. And this one. Next up is a cool air terraria. And the two moons, which are just asteroids. Next up is this one. And with like four actual moons, which is this one. This one, this one, this one, and this one. Actually, there are five. Whoops. Anyways, next one. Wait. We already been here. Whoops. I said there was a moon over there. Sorry. Someone just entered. Anyways. Okay, so we have that planet. And we have this planet. And the winds are just asteroids. Because this one is a pretty cool looking planet. With especially with the rings. So yeah. Anyways. Actually, I think I'm gonna end the video over here. It's probably gonna be a short one, but I will probably. I will just end this video. Before I end it, I'll find a cool solar system so we can set so we for the next episode. Just find an interesting solar system. I mean, let's look over here. Hey! This solar system has two that could have life. Let's start. I think I'm gonna end the video here. I'm gonna end the video here. So, I hope you enjoyed it, and if you enjoyed it, like the video, and if you want to see more, subscribe, and have an awesome day. Goodbye!